Alex.
Yeah, Talia, he basically said he has to get creative here because these two issues are connected. It's hard to drive down crime when you don't have a full force. Now, Thomas tells me he's particularly concerned about the shootings and homicides, but also car thefts. He doesn't love that we're the worst in the nation for that crime. Now, he's trying to focus on crime hotspots in the city, improving response time, shifting staff around, and trying to make the department just about as efficient as possible.
I've thought of some innovative ways to repurpose officers so that there's more officers to be able to respond to police calls, identifying those calls that don't necessarily need a police response, whether they can be reports can be taken online or over the phone.
And another issue is staffing. Thomas tells me he wants to add 188 uniformed officers over the next year, but admits they likely won't hit that target. Right now, with less staff, more officers are going to be working overtime. So I asked, how is he going to balance recruiting at record levels and preventing burnout? Take a listen.
I mean, it's going to be a challenge. It's going to be a challenge. You know, certainly it's not as easy as it once was to recruit officers to join any police department. I think that we have some innovative ideas with our recruiting team to really attract the kinds of people that the community wants to see serving them as police officers.
So this is a massive job, right? It's a lot to take on all at once, and on top of that, he's going to have a new boss to deal with. Denver elects a new mayor this spring. Thomas tells me he's confident the next mayor will see that he's the right man for this job. Jeremy?